Hi friends, let's create a liquid grunge effect in After Effects. It's easy enough for beginners, so you can repeat step by step. Create a new comp and name it Main. Create a background, then a text layer, and type in our text. We're using the AH Super Duper typeface. Create a new solid and name it Text Texture. Then let's apply a fractal noise effect to it. Set the fractal type to dynamic progressive and noise type to linear. Set the contrast and brightness as in the example. Go into transform controls and increase the scale. Set the complexity to 20, then in the sub settings, set the sub influence and sub scaling as we do, and that's it for our first texture. Select the text layer and apply Luma Matte to our text texture. Select the text and apply the roughen edges effect to it. Set the border, edge sharpness, and scale as here. Let's add some motion to the text. Add a wiggly selector and go to its properties. Set the position to 3 on the y-axis and rotation to 0.5. Set the wiggles per second to 0 and add an expression to the random seed property. Alt+ click and in the first line, type posterize time 5 and in the second line, random 10,000. Now let's animate the text texture. Select the texture layer, go to the fractal noise effect, and in the evolution options, Alt+ click on a random seed property and then copy and paste the expression from our wiggly selector. Let's add some blur. Create a new solid and apply the fractal noise effect to it. Set the fractal type to terrain, noise type to spline, contrast to 75, brightness to negative 65. In the transform, set the rotation and scale as in the video. Increase the complexity in the sub settings, change the sub influence, sub scaling, and sub rotation. Then rename this layer to blur texture and make it invisible. Create a new adjustment layer and add a compound blur effect to it. Set the source to effects and masks. Set the maximum blur to 8, and the blur texture as the blur layer. Select all the layers and pre-compose them. Name the pre-comp as main title. Then, create a new comp and name it displacement texture. Create a solid and add a fractal noise to it. Set the noise type to block. Set the contrast and brightness as here. Complexity to 1. In the transform properties, set the scale width, scale height, and offset turbulence on the x-axis. Alt+ click on the random seed property in the evolution options and type posterize time 5, random 10,000. Then, add a fastbox blur and set the blur radius to 11, check the repeat edge pixels parameter. Create a new shape layer. Color it black and place it in the middle. Add a fastbox blur to the shape, set the blur radius to 50, check repeat edge pixels. Rename the layer to fade. Create a new adjustment layer. Name it scatter and add a scatter effect to it. Set the scatter amount to 43. Check randomize every frame. Then add a posterized time effect and set the frame rate to 5. Go back to main comp, select the main title, and add a displacement map effect to it. Set the displacement texture as the displacement source. Set displace on the x-axis to 10 or 15 pixels. Do you want to elevate your video editing game? Find all you need on Easy Edit Stock. Templates, text effects, presets. Discover a world of versatile assets for your next video. Now let's add some texture to our background. We're using texture from Texture Labs. It's a newsprint paper 305 texture to be exact. Import the texture into our comp. Add tint effect, then set the scale to 50. Set the blending mode to overlay. Add a motion tile effect, mirror the edges and expand the output width and height to 200. Add the posterized time and random expressions as we do here. Add a transform effect, Alt+ click on the rotation property and add the following expressions. Add a fill effect to the main title comp and set the color to black. Create a new solid, name it BG. Then add levels and crush the texture's contrast a bit. To finish the visual composition, let's add some colorful shapes. And apply Fastbox Blur to them. Set the blending mode to multiply and add some random motion to the position of the shapes. Add posterize time and wiggle expressions. Then right-click on the position, select copy expression, and paste it to all the other shapes. Play with the settings a bit until you get an image like this. Let's also add some footage. Create a new comp, set the size to 1920 by 950 pixels. Name it footage and click OK. Drag your footage here. Go back to main comp and add the footage comp to the timeline. Let's apply some effects. Add tint and levels. Crank up the contrast in the levels. Now let's add some finishing touches to our design. We'll add some small text and some simple shapes to enhance the details. If you want to know how we did the in animation, watch our previous tutorial on top 4 text animation techniques. Our liquid grunge effect is finally ready.
If you like the result, make sure to hit the like button and follow our channel for more tutorials. See you in next video.